Okay, today I wanted to show you how to use the designer bass frog hook. I wanted to show you in particular how to easily put on the different WeedGuards that I like to use. I like the clone series one because it stays on very well. Some people have a little trouble with it though, because when they go to stretch it, sometimes they'll break it. Some people are very good at it, some people struggle. This simple tool up here, made from a hairpin, and by just bending the tines around to create little hooks, will make it ridiculously easy for anyone to attach either the clone series, which is made basically of silicone, the latex heavyweight, or the latex lightweight WeedGuards. I like to use all those WeedGuards in different situations, and I'm going to show you with this tool how easy it is now. You just take your hook, put the WeedGuard on the loop and the wire, then you take your tool, and you stick it through the hole, just squeeze it together, stick it through, whoops, stick it through the hole, okay, then you take it and put it down past the bar by passing in between the two arms. Go back to where you can catch the barb. And there it is, that easy. Really simple. You can find these hairpins in a beauty supply store. Okay, we're going to do the heavyweight latex. Just take your tool, put it through the latex WeedGuard, drag it down behind the barb, go through the two arms, and place it right on the barb. That easy. Anybody can do that. This is a very strong WeedGuard too, and it's very thick, so it gives a lot of hook point protection. But sometimes I like to use the lightweight WeedGuard, especially if I don't want the WeedGuard to look that obvious. Now this lightweight WeedGuard is the hardest to stretch, but it stays on very well once you get it on there. Got to get it inside the loop of the wire. Okay. You're going to have to really squeeze the tool down to get it through that little hole. Okay, let it spread back out again so the two arms are separated. Now you just pull it down, go through the hook point, and attach it right to the barb. See how easy that was? Anybody can do it. Of course, I can put these things on by hand even in the dark. Right, I'm closing my eyes. I just make a little loop. Then I slide across my nail. So if you don't have that tool with you, this is how I do it. I've seen other people do it other ways. That's the hardest one to put on, so if you can do that one by hand, I just did it with my eyes closed. And once again, you can use a lady's hairpin, or you can even use a paper clip if you want to make one of these tools. It makes it extremely easy. One of the best things about these hooks and these WeedGuards is that they're very adjustable. You can actually pull that wire with a pair of needle nose, and it'll actually change the angle of protection, and it'll also increase the tension, giving you more protection. That way, if you're fishing some kinds of cover like logs, or you're making longer casts where it hits harder, you'll have more tension, and it won't trip if you hit a log or a lily pad. But you can reduce it to make it easier to get a hook set. Don't worry, even at the strongest tension that I often use, you can still hook a bass very easily. You can also get more protection by using the heavier weight WeedGuard, the heavyweight latex WeedGuard. It's thicker, so it'll actually give you more protection for the hook point. One thing about using it, though, is make sure that you anchor the rubber on the barb well. Sometimes the barb does not want to penetrate and hold on to the rubber, so make sure it sinks in deeply, and it'll actually stay in place better for you.